moment because it happens between two very important summits. Last week there was a job creation summit, and week after next, in fact, next week there's a health summit, and the following week will be an investment summit. And as I was sitting this morning, I said that this summit, or all these summits, if only we could just sit and listen, maybe all the answers will come from these discussions. And I want to premise my response and intervention with the following words. That our prime purpose in life is to help others. If we don't, we should at least not help them. So, I've heard all of what you said, and I just wanted to say, last year sometime, I asked Mr. Mulewa to help me with my presentation to Parliament. And as I was presenting, it was in response to the Medicine Innovation Bill. Because it was Medicine Innovation Bill, I took advantage of talking about hemp and its potential in bringing about change and its potential in the industrial sector. But I think what is important is almost like South Africa just woke up.
No way.
Just woke up to hemp. Whilst historically, the Japanese and others have used hemp. Have used them, is it better?
Yes.
And these countries include China, Canada, US, Russia, and some of the European countries. I've heard how hemp can be used, I've read about it, but today I saw evidence. Evidence about fiber, sealing boards, paper, brick manufacturing, cosmetics, rope, canvas. I've seen the dresses, the bags that Dr. Kurene once demonstrated. She came for the first time at MCC. In fact, I must confess, at the time I could not relate because in my head I could only think medicine. And I did not understand how one could move from medicine to producing a bag, to producing a mat for Mercedes Benz, and a bag. But I have seen it, and I've come to appreciate it. But of course, as we talk about THC with its low yield, I must remind you that as we approved the license at the time, because the research permit was issued to Agricultural Research Council, we then at the time also got a report from the police that they had cut into a fence, and it created a lot of panic at the time. But I actually wondered as to, because we had to stop the research project just because of the fence. And I'm wondering, did anyone steal anything at the time?
No.
And did we expose anyone to harm? Particularly because we were told that the hemp yields were low. And if they were, and if that was the case, what was the panic for? But of course, the hemp trial started in 1999, and it was a collaborative effort. But we have not learned from that. I mean, I've come to understand that we use evidence to make decisions, to respond. And globally, there's been a steady demand for hemp as a raw material for individual industrial use. And I want to pause and share a story. A story about when, because I've worked for the World Health Organization, and my responsibility was also about traditional medicine. So I had to develop guidelines for the world for complementary medicine and traditional medicine. But at the time, when I was there, we had an outbreak of bad flu. And at the time, you might have recalled that China responded. But subsequent to that, we had swine flu. And we informed that swine flu, globally, we needed Tamiflu for treatment. And Tamiflu is derived from oseltamivir. I thought, let me divert a bit and just tell you how the world responds. But I went to investigate where oseltamivir comes from. It is actually derived from a plant called star anise. Star anise is actually used for spices. Some of you use it to cook. But star anise, at the time, was a plant that was used for extraction of shikimic acid, which is used as a starting material for oseltamivir. And what happened then is that there were floods in China, and the world was in crisis because the floods, they couldn't get the starting material. The moral of the story here is we do work and we wait for another country and wait for a crisis and wake up and start thinking, can we start investigating how to make shikimic acid or start thinking about how we use star anise? The difference here with hemp is that we've done the research, we've got the data. So the question is, why don't we move? Why don't we just take a leap of faith?
Yes! Yes.
So my question is, based on this recent Concord judgment, I've heard your message about Wild West. I'm as anxious as all of you are. And I see an opportunity for us to arrest the Wild West. And based on the presentations, I would like to say we can actually move from ancient anesthesia to modern dispensary. And most of the requests for use for individual patient treatment, we've seen and we've got evidence again from our local research. Just to say, this is not research generated elsewhere. South African research. May I remind you, when I was in the Medicine Control Council at the time, we received requests to approve cannabis for the treatment of leprosy. Yeah. Now, I don't know if we still have leprosy, but at the time, for the few cases that we had. But we know that it is effective for severe muscle spasms, severe pain for patients with multiple sclerosis, severe nausea for wasting patients, for patients with cancer, severe epileptic seizures when there are no options, severe chronic pain, and the list goes on. But I can tell you that very limited products in South Africa.
We must talk.
So we have to respond to the need. There is already guidelines with framework to guide growers for medicinal cannabis for cultivation, manufacturing, and supply of standardized high-quality medicinal cannabis products. We need support for development of best practices, meaning this industry must promote best practices against their members. Now, when you talk self-regulation, the first thing you do amongst yourselves, you develop code of practice. It can't come from us. It must be yourselves. You must come up with good code of practice and promote that code of practice. So when we talk as government, we'll say, this is the code of practice. Meaning we'll use your code of practice and we repeat the same message. But may I request, you have to do it yesterday. Yeah. The next one is about the framework. The framework, and the team will talk to you later about the technical details. Framework for cultivation, for extraction, for testing, for manufacturing, importation, exportation, and distribution. Now, in your discussions, you did not address this, and I would like you to include it. It's about potential for exports to other countries. So add it in your list as an industry association. It would actually be humbling for me to go to another country and they show me a brick or they show me a fiber, an insulator, you know, from South Africa, produced by yourself. You left a very important department. When you leave today, it's not only tourism, it is the department, it's DECO, right? Yes. Our international relations.
Yes.
Let them be the ones who write our missions and tell them about this potential. Let them communicate our goals and tell them that this is what South Africa is about. It can't be about when people come and visit. When they leave, they go to another country, they might have forgotten.
Yes.
But DECO must be a constant reminder.
When you say mission, you mean our embassy?
Embassy. Okay. So, for us to succeed, and I want us to engage the Department of Water and Sanitation. I'll tell you why. You know, if you go to the agricultural sector, you need water.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
So the campaign for the safe use of water, the campaign for responsible use of water becomes important. You don't want to be growing and they say you can't water. Then you can't then have the crops. So you need that department. So add them to the list. So that as you engage, you have them.
Yes.
Meaning in your list, I'm adding other departments that you need. Okay? I know you need the Department of Agriculture, Health, and so on. But I also want you, maybe your delegation, humbly so, I would like you to engage the security cluster. The security cluster is police, you know, all of them, justice and so on. So that is an opportunity to explain that you are not the bad guys. I'm saying that for the following reason. You know Bolivia grows coca, okay? They chew it for medicinal purposes, so for heights. It has been the same. They traveled this route, but they had a very interesting campaign. They said if it's green, it's good, and if it's white, it's bad. When they say if it's green, it's good, it means it's when it's a copper leaf. So if it's white, it's when it's cocaine, and it's bad. So you need to have campaigns in your education to start telling people about eco-friendly initiatives. So for the social dimensions, I wanted to say that, yes, South Africa has a serious burden of substance abuse, but also illegal trade linked to human trafficking. We've seen the communities take to the streets. So we want you to be the face helping us fight substance abuse.
Oh, yes.
You must actually call and invite the advocates for substance abuse to fight side by side with you, yes, so that the community can see the value of the work you do, the same way as the Bolivians try to do. Society and communities need to be educated. You know, the first thing that comes out, and I'm saying with honorable colleagues here, I'll call you honorable because you are all
Yes. No way.
The first thing that the community, you know, when I tell people I have to address the DACA issue, the first thing they think smoke.
Yeah. Yes.
So you need to start telling them about hemp and its potential, the medicinal options that are there. So the public education is extremely important. I've been looking at the psychiatric surveillance and some of the data that have come up, and I want to salute you for the following reason. Responsible use. I don't know how many times I must repeat this. Responsible use and age limit. Age limit, because I've seen the data about teenagers in schools. And that data, remember, when a teenager starts smoking, they don't ask for permission from a parent. When they start drinking, they don't ask for permission from a parent. So when they use cannabis, they will not ask for permission. So it is for that reason that we have to take our communities along with us and educate them and protect our children and our teenagers. So we must keep it away from children and have responsible private adult use. And I keep on repeating it, responsible adult private use. So what is it that will do to reach the potential based on your asks? I agree. We cannot and we should not miss this season. I'll tell you why. We've got 2 years to write the law.
Yes.
Now it will be a missed window of opportunity. Now if you don't do it, I think you might have seen the advert. The Coca-Cola container, a beer container of cannabis. We can allow for that if we want to, but is it fair?
No.
So in this country, you need fair trade.
Yes.
So, but you need to move fast by ensuring you can train growers, train them on SAPRA guidelines. Those guidelines are out there. They need to know them, they need to internalize them. You need to run workshops with the Department of Agriculture, with ARC, on good agricultural practices. You don't want to give people plants and herbs that contain a lot of okay? You also, we will be consulting you on how best we can amend the law so that it's responsive whilst protecting the public. advocacy and education. I don't know how many times I can repeat it. But also, tell us, because you are in the sector, tell us what are those strategies to prevent, to protect the children? What are those preventative measures? I've heard that, and I found this quite profound, where you say you don't want alcohol, tobacco used together in the same place.
Yes.
So that's a message that must come out here so that the South African public knows. In working with various government departments, please also identify focal points. You know, what I've seen with a number of industries and sectors, when they send multiple people and they come with many voices, it sends mixed messages.
Yes.
You come with one voice,
yes.
You are listened to.
Yes.
Okay?
Unite.
Again, message production of quality products,
yes.
To create goodwill. Meaning, when it comes out of this country, when you want to say how proudly South African, it must be because it's a product that meets the standards of quality. We need to also get to work with institutions that promote healthy living and well-being.
Yes.
But also be a model for us on how best we can control it. So that when we meet our international obligations, when we report to the UN, we can go back and say, this is how South Africa is managing this. Also, in the engagement of international agencies, international institutions, we need to also ensure that we can learn from this experience. But there's one partner that you must put alongside, the media. Ask for an opportunity to run a workshop with them so that the media can understand fully what this is about. You know, media can educate the public, but they can also tell them something else other than what you say.
Yes.
So these debates about lens can make a use of them. But I think we need to start telling them to conduct what I call essential research that helps us respond to the needs of the country. Another department that must be on your list, because I think everything we've been talking about is environmentally friendly, is the Department of Environmental Affairs. So I must say, I'm really, really, really humbled by this. Indeed, I can say formally, as a Department of Health, I'm the Director General, I can say formally that I recognize this
book. Oh, wait.
Is meant to change
our lives
of South
Africans. Away!
So with that, I would like to really thank you for inviting me.
Oh, yeah.
Get organized and give you all the farms that are ready.
Yo, I want the team, because they're going to talk to you in the afternoon to tell you how far we are. I've been informed that there are 27 applications and I don't know about 17, but 3 are ready. That's what I was passed on immediately. So they'll tell you the details.
And they
but
have...
remember, I want to say formally and without fear or favor. If you read the act, unfortunately it says the director general must be defendants. So I'm in trouble already.
Because after this she goes, I'm not going to ask her questions, her team is here, she's got to be excused, she's got a crisis. But that was on the medicine, Sabra, the hemp. I'm seeing Tony says, Dr. Ndego hemp.
Yes, this is why I say, remember, I have teams that work on this. I would like them to engage you further during the session. It will be very difficult for me to commit without understanding. But for now, I was just telling you that I've got something hanging over my head. The law says DG must issue a permit. So I am this year. I don't want police to take me to court.
But we decided we